my channel Creative Art. I am Nilima and today we are going to make this beautiful eco-friendly Lord Ganesha idol using a DIY kit which contains natural clay and a mold using which you can make this beautiful Lord Ganesha idol yourself at home. So friends, do watch the complete video to make it yourself and do subscribe my channel friends for more creative art painting videos and do press the bell icon to get notification for each video I post every week. So now let's quickly check out the materials. Friends, this is the DIY mold and make natural clay Ganesha kit which has premium refined natural clay in it. So let's start by opening this kit. First of all, I'm going to remove the secured sides. Let's open it now. In this DIY kit, we get a Ganesha mold. So this is actually a plastic mold. So you have to be very careful while using it. Next is the instruction manual, which you have to follow step by step to make a beautiful Ganesha. Next is craft wool. So I can see that this is fiber wool, which you have to mix with the natural clay. And this is the clay. It looks very refined and smooth. So I think this will be just perfect for making our Ganesha. So first of all, let's start by reading our instruction manual. The first step says grease the mold with little oil. It can be baby oil, coconut oil, or any vegetable oil. This will help the mold to pop out easily from the mold once dry. The next step is mix the craft wool with the clay and knead it well. Add a little water if required. This will make the mold strong and prevent cracks formation when the clay is dry. Okay, so this is the use of wool. And the third step is add some small pieces of clay one at a time into the mold. Every time press the clay firmly into the mold for better shape. The fourth step, once the mold is completely full, turn it upside down. Press the flat side against a smooth surface for a uniform flat back. Fifth step is let the mold dry naturally. It may require 24 hours or more depending upon the weather and other factors. Sixth step, once the Ganesha mold is completely dry, pop it out of the mold. The seventh step is to make the base out of the remaining clay for the Ganesha and then make that base deep in this way and place Ganesha in the depth of that clay. So finally, this is how your Ganesha should look. So let's start now friends. You can buy this kit for MRP ₹499, but now friends, you can buy it for ₹359 as this DIY kit is currently 20% off. And friends, do use my promo code which is NILIMA5, NILIMA5, to get extra 5% off on your every purchase from Little Birdie Itsy Bitsy. So let's start the DIY now friends. Now friends, let's start our DIY and first of all, let's start by separating the craft wool. Using just two fingers, just separate the craft wool and this way and place it in the box. So now we have finally separated the complete wool and this is the quantity we have got out of that small chunk of wool. So now we'll start by opening our clay packet. And as you can see, this is an air seal packet. So be very careful while opening this. I'm using my cutter and gently cutting it out. And you can clearly see there is one more packet inside. So I'm going to open that one. Now friends, we'll start by preparing our base. So here is some home cotton and a little bit of baby oil. So I'll pour a little bit of baby oil in the home cotton. Now friends, using this cotton, I'm going to grease the entire surface of this mold so that when the clay gets dry inside the mold, it will pop out easily. So this part is done now. Let's start preparing the clay. Now friends, I'll start by cutting out the clay piece by piece. I can feel it's so soft and refined, and then add just a little bit of the wool and start mixing it with the clay. It's perfect. It mixes up perfectly in the clay. You can clearly see it's so difficult to pull out. So here is my clay beautifully mixed. I'll keep this chunk aside and start mixing more. This is a really a fun process. I'm just loving doing it. If you need a little bit of water, just add a little bit of water. Don't let the clay dry before you put it in the mold. Now friends, I have finally completed mixing all the wool in the clay, and these are the clay chunks, and this is our plastic mold which is greased using oil and ready. And now gently friends, I'll start placing the clay part by part in our mold in this way. Press it gently. So this is how it looks from the front. I do have a lot of clay in my hand, so you won't be able to see it clearly. Each time you have to place clay piece by piece. Once we have filled up the entire mold with the clay, start smoothing the clay from the back side by gently pressing it, and also make sure that it is completely filled up. There is no gap. If needed, use a little bit of extra clay. I'm going to make it smooth in this way. Now friends, when your mold is completely filled up with clay, just give it a gentle press from the back side and start smoothing the clay in this way. You can also use just a little bit of water in your fingers. Let me turn it, and this is how it looks from the front side. I'll just smooth it using some water, and this is going to be our final step. So it's also smooth from the back side now. You can also turn it out on a plain smooth surface like this, and then give it a gentle press so that the back side becomes smooth. So now friends, I'm going to let it get dry for 24 hours and then we'll remove our mold. Now friends, after 24 hours, the clay has got dried up partially. So let's try taking out the mold. And this is how beautiful Ganesha we get out of this mold. You can clearly observe there are just a few gaps which we can easily fill up just by using a little bit of water in our fingers. We have to give it a finishing touch in this way so that if there are any breakage or unfinished part, it will be easily filled up. And this is how I'm going to give it my finishing touch on all the parts. But anyhow, we have received such a beautiful clay mold out of it. So now I'll do the finishing part and then we'll start the coloring part. Now friends, the top layer of clay has almost got dried up 80%. So now I'm going to use some of my sculpture tools. So these are the ones I do have. And using this, I'm going to highlight few features of our sculpture. So this is how you have to do it. First of all, using a pointed stick or a knife, just draw the shape outline you get to see in this way. इसके बाद मैं यूज करने वाली हूँ कुछ इस तरह का पॉइंटी टूल, जिससे कि हम इसी लाइंस के ऊपर से जाएंगे और एक गहरा सा कर्व बनाएंगे शेप, जिससे कि जो फीचर्स है हाथों के, फिंगर्स के, और भी उभर जाएंगे। आपको कई तरह के टूल्स मिलते हैं, तो आप को जो भी टूल कंफर्टेबल होता है उसे यूज़ करके आप अपने स्कल्पचर को शेप दीजिए और एक स्मूथनेस भी दीजिए। Now after doing the sculpture, just slightly remove the extra clay using brush. So now friends, in the same way, using different sculpture tools, you can do the sculpture part. You can also add few designs like this, and like these ones I have done on the top of the mukut. So that is completely your choice. So now I'm going to show you how I have added these designs on the stage. So main use kar rahi hu kuch is tarah ka jo sculpture tool hai, aur isse hum gently design par press karenge kuch is tarah se. तो ये डिज़ाइन यहाँ क्रिएट हो जाएगा, आप देख सकते हैं. तो हमें यहाँ पे बहुत ही खूबसूरत सा एक डिज़ाइन मिल गया है. मैं सेम कुछ बैंगल्स पे भी करना चाहती हूँ, बिल्कुल ही हल्का प्रेसिंग करूँगी. सो नाउ फ्रेंड्स, इन द सेम वे आई हैव डन द सेम डिज़ाइनिंग पार्ट ऑन द गणेश जी होल्डिंग लड्डूस एंड हिज ज्वेलरी बैंगल्स एंड द मुकुट sides. So this is how finally it looks. So for coloring friends, I'm going to use so many different and beautiful shades. You can make your own choice, but make sure friends, as we are making a eco-friendly Ganesha, we will always take care of nature first. So for that, we are going to use a non-toxic color, which is a fevicryl acrylic color. I'm going to use a variety of shades. For skin, I'm going to use fresh tint color and portrait pink. For dhotar, we can use variety of shades from red, yellow, orange to purple. That is your choice. We'll also need gold, silver and medium too, and rest of the colors are absolutely your choice. So let's start the coloring part friends. Now friends, part by part we will start coloring, and as this is the first time that we are going to color on clay, so I would like to do a priming part. So you can either use a texture white or a gesso for priming, but I'm directly going to make use of color, as I have professionally seen many times coloring idols. So I'm going to use two different acrylic colors for my base. The first one is gold and the second one is white. I'm going to use the gold color on all the jewelry part, the dhotar and mukut, and I'm going to use white color as a base for all the skin part as well as the stage on which Ganesha is sitting. So now using a flat hair brush, I'm going to start the coloring part from golden, and first of all I'll start doing it from the top, which is mukut. If you don't want to do rest of the colors, you can simply use golden color and color only the jewelry, mukut, stage and the dhotar. Even that looks very beautiful. I'm going to show you that in my next upcoming video, which is in Hindi. I do want to color the modak as gold. And I would also like to color the dhotar as gold first. Now after doing the gold color, this is how our Ganesha looks. So now friends, let's start coloring the skin part as white first. So in the same way friends, I will be coloring all the skin part as white now. Now friends, I have finally completed doing the white color for my base and golden color on the jewelry wherever we need it. And in the remaining part, I have chosen to do black color like this. So I have kept the base as black, and here was some empty space, so I let it be black for now. I'll later on decide what to do right there. So after doing the golden on the dhoti part, I decided to do it yellow. So I did use some yellow color and did just the tapping on the uplifted part of the clay. And this is how it looks, a shading with golden and the color yellow. So yellow is not looking very bright, but the golden is also clearly visible. So that makes the sculpture look much more beautiful. So now I'll show you how I did color in this part by using yellow for the bottom piece right here. So this time I'm going to use chrome yellow, the same one I used on dhoti, and I'm going to use a paint brush instead of tapping. So I'm going to tap my paint brush in this way and then gently color the top first, right like this, and then drag the color in this way. This makes the coloring part a bit easy. I'm going to repeat the same step to brighten up more yellow. And this is how I did yellow on the golden, just by tapping it on the top in this way. If you want to smooth the color, just drag it and it will get smoother. So friends, in the same way you have to color the Angavastram. So I'm going to use maybe pink or red color for this part, but for now let's start coloring the skin part, as I have done on the right side of both the hands and foot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a neon pink and fresh tint color for coloring the skin part. So first of all, I'm going to use neon pink in my paintbrush and I'm going to place it on the deep parts of the skin, like wherever there is a curve, in this way. And then I'm going to use the fresh tint color, do it on the other parts in this way, and start merging it with the neon pink. And this is how we are going to get the shading. Make sure each time you do it on a small part, just a small part. Just wipe your brush if you have some extra color. And if you want to highlight some part, use the fresh tint directly on it in this way. I'll add a little bit of more neon pink in the depth of the ears in this way and mix it with the fresh tint. So this is how you have to do the shading all over in the skin part. This is a very time-taking process, so take all your time, but do all the things with patience. I'm going to keep the face very, very simple. First, I'm going to do just skin color on the half part. Just do the coloring part by part. And now, I'm going to use neon pink in my number 0 brush and mark wherever there is or there should be a depth using the neon pink color. So this is how I'm going to do it. And gently mix it with the skin tone in this way. And then I'm going to use fresh tint color again and highlight the parts where I want it to look lighter. In this way, gently merge it, use neon pink again, just a little bit of pink under the eye in this way and right here. So you see, the shading on the right side is exactly how you have to do it on the left side. Now we will let this part get dry. Until that, let's start doing the skin color on this part. This time I will be taking neon pink first. So this is how, friends, you have to do the skin color on the face, as I have shown you on the right side. The same you have to do it on the left side. Just color the depth of the hands using neon pink first and then use the fresh tint, mix a little bit of neon pink with it and do the shading part, as you see I have done here, and then finally add the highlights using the lighter shade. This is how you have to color the skin part. I have already done this part. In the same way, I will be doing on the right side, and then I will show you how to do the snake and the background black part we have done. Okay? So now, in the same way, I have done coloring of rest of the skin part, and I have also done coloring of the clothing part. And now, there are just 2 to 3 things remaining. The first one is snake, and the second one is the Angavastram. For that, I'm going to use the purple color and I will be highlighting it using ultramarine blue. So gently using my brush for purple and fill that space completely. As this is a sculpture painting, it's very much easier if I do painting without camera, because it's really difficult to get all the angles in this way. So first, I'll just fill up the complete area using purple. Now after doing the purple color, I'm going to use ultramarine blue to fill up in the gaps in this way. Just a gentle bright highlight. I'll use some more purple in this part. So now this is ready. Let's start doing the snake. Now we're going to start coloring snake, and for that I'm going to use a black acrylic color. You can clearly see the snake has a few patterns on it, so that is going to help us in the coloring. And now I'm going to use metallic wax from Little Birdie, and it has three colors. I'm going to use copper blaze. You get 3 to 4 colors in this metallic wax. I'm going to use the copper blaze. Other than that, you can also use gold or silver, which we are going to use on different parts. So when you open this packaging, you get this kind of copper wax, which you can easily apply just using your finger. So I'm going to take copper wax in this way and gently drag it on the snake. And you can see how beautiful it looks on the texture. It easily gets applied on the texture. If you want to add any detailing, simply use a paintbrush. Just tap, tap, tap a little bit of glaze and spread it around in this way. So I'm going to do the same on all the black part of the Ganesha you can see here. I'm going to use a paintbrush and take this blaze and apply it on the inner parts in this way. And I'm going to do the same even on the sides where we have done black, so that each black is covered up with gold or bronze blaze. Simply use your finger to take some wax and tap, tap, tap. Easily the beautiful shapes will be visible. So in the same way, you can also use gold or silver metallic wax. There are more colors available. So now finally friends, we have completed doing the coloring part, and this is how beautiful our Lord Ganesha idol looks. So friends, do give it a try, make it yourself this festive season, and do share this video friends so that more and more people can make Lord Ganesha idol themselves at home and celebrate this season safely in their homes. Have a nice day and thank you for watching.